it really felt like an experience of four individuals, young people, all going through something crazy together, and finding each other and coming together, and that was really the heart of the film. Ben Grimm is a kind of atypical American teenager. I think he's someone who, is in that point of his life where he doesn't know what he's going to do next. He's kind of about to finish high school. He doesn't have a lot of prospects. He's very average, I would say. He's as average as they come. I think the one thing that makes him stand out, I think, is that he's very protective. He's very protective of himself. He's very protective of his friends. A lot of this film has themes to do with parents and lack thereof of parents, or people becoming orphans, or redefining the idea of family. I think by the end of it, they all kind of are their own family. America's first family. Ben Grimm is Reed Richards' parent. He's his father. He's his protector. He's the guardian. He's the one that looks out for him. You know, he's also the one that, even if he doesn't necessarily understand all of his scientific analogies or his vocabulary, which a lot of it would go over Ben's head anyway, he at least understands what he's trying to do or who he's trying to be, and he connects with him. What do you do when you wake up in the hospital bed and, like, you're made of rocks, or your limbs are spread out across the room as far as you can see, or, you know, you're literally on fire? It's probably quite a sobering moment, I would imagine. I think Ben gets the worst of it, if I'm honest. I think I have the worst affliction. I'm literally a rock with eyes. Your life is forever changed. All those plans of potentially maybe getting into college on a baseball scholarship, maybe leaving your house, maybe finding your first apartment, finding your first girlfriend, finding your first, all that stuff, gone. I mean, like, your life as a normal individual is gone, is removed. So all you have, surely, is the people that you experienced that horrible atrocity with. It's a fun family film. It's a fun summer movie. Mars is hands down just a great actor. I mean, it's hard to, you know, I've seen a lot of his movies that he's already made. I've seen stuff of him on this movie, just looking at playback and stuff. He's genuinely, like, a great actor. He makes Reed a very complicated individual. I think Reed should be a complicated person. We have a great relationship off screen. I mean, as soon as I met him, we just had a great rapport together. We have a lot of fun together. We laugh a lot. And I think that hopefully will come through in the movie, that these guys are childhood friends. And even though now there's this gap and this divide and this distance because of what's happened to them, they're still friends at heart, you know. The stakes are so high and it's so fantastical. And the sometimes the instinct is to make it so. He's really pulling the reins back and saying, like, we don't need to do that. Everything is real. And seriously, every single set that I've been on this movie, you know, from the Baxter corridors, or, you know, to his dorm room, or to the quantum gate, or, you know, wherever it is, there's always a sense of, like, this is a real place. This really exists. It's very different, I think, when people see this film. That, you know, they're going to come out of the theater and say, you have to see Fantastic Four. And people are going to say, why? And they say, you just have to see it. Because it's not like anything I think I've seen, really, within this genre. With these kinds of characters and, you know, powers and superheroes and villains and stuff, you know, I just haven't seen anything like this before.
Hello, Valerie here with some fascinating movie facts from Ant-Man. Ant-Man's helmet is influenced by the helmets of Iron Man and the Autobot Transformer Bumblebee. According to Michael Douglas, the costume for Paul Rudd had to be altered because of his muscles. Rudd had gone on an extensive training and workout regimen in order to build the proper muscle size for a superhero. But since Rudd had become so muscular, Douglas said he was so cut that they had to soften his costume up with all the built-in six-packs and all of that. Wow. Download our Film Is Now app, available for both Android and iOS.